Most of the time in our Crime File series, you hear from the parents of homicide victims. Well, a lot of times the victims are parents themselves.
Oh, 5 months ago, these sisters had never met.
Seeing his face on a obituary just doesn't seem right.
Their father's funeral was their first encounter.
I want to say that he was a special dad.
Me and him was getting to know each other, and like, ever since that happened, like, it feels like I can't be the same no more.
Their lives have been completely disrupted, and it's happened so sudden, and it's so permanent.
Police say someone gunned down 37-year-old Antonio Shanklin last fall. Just before 6, one September morning, officers found him dead outside a home at 38th and Wabash. He had left behind two girls, 10 and 13.
And it's taken a bit of their innocence away.
Monica Roberts' nonprofit directly helps Aniyah and Tyahna and many other kids in the metro whose parents have been murdered.
They're now subjected to very serious adult topics that most adults have a difficult time relating to.
Her dad's gone. She's never gonna be able to see him again.
That person took a piece of me.
The girls are afraid.
She's scared to walk in the store because that person could be right behind you or in front of you. It's hurting me, my sister, my family, because they haven't turned themselves in.
Like when it's a school day, I just feel sad because every school day I go to school, I don't want to talk to nobody. Because I feel sad every day.
The only good in this grief, the bond between a set of two young girls.
They can be there for each other more than we can. And they understand what each other are going through, so.
She's my big sister, and we can take care of each other and have each other's back, even though we're sad.
At least we got each other to go through with.
They hope sharing their own pain will soften the hearts of the people who can call Crime Stoppers to solve this case.
It didn't end at the funeral service. For these little girls, they are carrying this with them for the rest of their lives. And I truly beg the public to give them some bit of closure. They have a lot of sleepless nights, and they live in fear of the unknown.
If you know what happened to Antonio or you know who has that information, please share it with Crime Stoppers. They are not the police and they have no way of tracking or identifying you. Remember, there is up to a $10,000 reward for the right information. The number's there to reach them on your screen. I'm Megan Dillard, Fox 4 News.